bootstrap 100 replicates. You got the results? Now see that I've just changed the name over here, Staphylococcus. I couldn't change the species name. Whatever the file I was having, it was lacking that species name. Now see, this is Kimura. I have used Kimura Kimura model of distance calculation model. So Kimura neighborhood joining, Kimura UPGMA here. Okay, so all are clustered together. This is maximum likelihood method, this is maximum parsimon method, this is Kimura neighborhood joining, but it is bootstrap method. This is Kimura UPGMA bootstrap. See what 100 is showing there. 100 means 100 time. I have just calculated 1000 tree. Okay, bootstrapping. So out of 1000, all 1000 times this is appearing in similar way. Means 1000 tree, same pattern. Clostridia 3, 1, 2. There are out groups of all the others. You know. But there may be the variation. This is, I think, 69 something. Mycoplasma 1 and 3, 69 times. 69% or 690 times they are coming in the similar fashion. And that's it is the majority rule. Majority rule means out of 1000, it may appear in different patterns. Means one may pair with all of these. Mycoplasma, one may pair with any other organism in bootstrap. But number of times what are the maximum number of times it is pairing with other organisms, that will be selected. So as 690 times it is appearing with Mycoplasma 3, so that has selected. Then next, Mycoplasma 2. So parsimony method may give you bootstrap method, bootstrapping or replication may give you good solutions, but may also deviate from your original data. So that time you need to morphological character. So you see means anytime it can move to the other, it can pair with the other organism also, though it's similar maximally with Mycoplasma 3. So that time you have to look for the morphological characteristic. Now see, every means this is, it's coming here also, Kimura method, and this is NJ method, similar type, there is no difference, you can compare it, just draw. Or even this is maximum likelihood method also, it's showing similar things, Mycoplasma, and so even maximum parsimony method also, it's showing the similar patterns. Means all three are here drawn, here Clostridium 2, here Clostridium 2 and Clostridium 1, similar way, but the branch length is more, means they are closer, this one, here also it is closer. The pattern of drawing, or even Clostridium, these three, just like this one is branch and this one is branch, total, because the distance starts from this line, here the point 0 to A, that will start from this point. Okay, then this one NJ and UPGMA. So which tree is suitable? So all are showing a good way, good relationship. They have clustered Mycoplasma together, Staphylococcus together, Bacillus together, Lactobacillus in one group, and Streptococcus in one group, and Clostridium in one group. And it's a fact that Clostridia, they distantly, so it has shown outgroup. Here also they are outgroup, here also they are outgroup, here also. But if you want, I can select these three. Why? In case of only UPGMA, Kimura model, the Clostridia has been included inside and Mycoplasma is just outside. And it's a fact also some Mycoplasma, they are similar to Clostridia, and some are, they are close to Bacillus. Factor. Mycoplasma lost most of their genomes, even Streptococcus and Staphylococcus. Mycoplasma essential genes are lost in them, degraded or degenerated, and during the evolutionary time period. And if I see the history, codon research analysis, that time after some of the Mycoplasma, they are highly closely related to Clostridia, codon research pattern, and some are, they are showing with the Bacillus. So this tree, I know the history, so that's what this is highly diverged now, because lot of changes has been occurred. Means some genes, which are, means what Darwin's, that's in Lamarck's, the organ which is not used may extinct. That is also similar case in this organism. That may be true. Mycoplasma, some genes were not required for them, so that has been degenerated, or that has been eliminated from them, so that is not present. Even in case of Streptococcus thermophilus, it is not present. But Clostridia and Bacillus, they are soil dwelling bacteria, their genome size in bacillus, it's more than 5,000 genes. Means around approximate 5,000 genes are there. 3,000 to 5,000 genes, highest. Then in Clostridia also, 3,500 to 5,000. They're also having the showing the same gene. But in case of Lactobacillus staphylococcus, they're having just 2,000 average gene. Number of genes present, ORF, not gene, ORF they are present. In case of except Lactobacillus, one species over there, that is one that's having the 3000 genes over there, that's exceptional. Otherwise, they are having two average two. And Mycoplasma, lowest range Mycoplasma genitalium with just average of 450 gene around 480 genes, and Mycoplasma hyponeumonia. So that's one having around 1000 genes ORFs over there. So they are shorting. So these trees, if I see the morphological character, then this tree is suitable for my selection. But my five trees are giving similar type of patterns. This one, this one, this one, this one. Okay. But again, this UPGMA Kimura, it's showing clustering this one, Mycoplasma outward. Then again, this one, in case of maximum parsimony or likelihood method, their Clostridium is outside, this is outside, and this is here also it is outside Clostridium. So 1, 2, 3, 4, NJ, but just except Kimura UPGMA and bootstrapping method of UPGMA. They're just bringing Mycoplasma outside. So this is the case I'm telling you. Means what factor, my factors, what I'm telling you. If I see the morphology, then this tree is true. What I studied the codon is, I need the further study. Then I may come to this point because this is also true. 16S RNA is conserved, that's why it is showing. So it may have some other parameters for calculations or distances. This one, UPGMA, the model, Kimura model, that may suit this. Okay, so I have used UPGMA for my clustering. So your tree banaya, 16S RNA, I have used that things. But that was the main clustering. But you can find, outgrouping is the different thing. Okay, so here Clostridium is placed most close to this, Mycoplasma is diverse. Next, maybe Mycoplasma may form because bacterial evolution is very faster as compared to the human or higher organism. So that may form. I think that's a clear to you. Means how you can analyze that depends on you. My perception or whatever the data I got, morphological, on that basis I will choose UPGMA method. I can support it. Okay, but some things okay, but there is no change. Only Mycoplasma and Clostridium, they are going. Okay, there is a change. Otherwise, if those are systematized, they will choose that method. Means UPGMA, maximum likelihood, parsimony and neighborhood churning method. Now this is RAPD data, okay, I have just bootstrap UPGMA, bootstrap NJ and NJ. So there is as such, okay, you can find. But RAPD data, bootstrap I told is okay, 100. But in that case also you need to look after the what? Morphological characters to compare. Just four bands if you are comparing, that's why I said, okay, don't miss any bands on the gel. That may affect the data. While drawing, why I said you put the scale, when you are using the computer, because all today everything is automated, you just have to put the gel documentation system, put the gel over there, capture the image, and there is gel compare is the software, commercial one, it will just tell you how the lines, parallel lines, but when you are doing manually, that image is also what happens sometimes, if you are not taking an image or visualization, if you place a darker side, so it will appear darker, some band you may miss. So when you are taking the image, only that time observe where the gel bands are present. And then also see, draw manually if you work on. So you may not miss one band. Draw it with the lines. Because collinear, because it's a part of a movement of the that band. Slightly it may differ with 100 base pairs or 50 base pairs. So it's moving. So always better way is to draw the line and then give one line as one character. One character or one trait, a second line as a second trait or second allele, third as a third. So maximum try to cover up maximum points or character and then draw the binary. So if you have number of binary characters, so that will be easy for clustering. If you have just two characters, you can't cluster. You will get only two groups. Three characters, you can get three groups. or number of, that's what I said, ki number of tags or number of characters may brings you number of trees, number of clustering. Okay, so always have a maximum characters. So when you have the RAPD or RFLP data also, you better study, get the morphological characters also. Okay, so this one. Now this was the parse tree we have seen, okay, and this was the parse tree converted to NCMEC format. I have converted this tree, parse tree, to NCMEC format. Actually it's not NCMEC, it's a NewVic, okay, NewVic format, and by Jaccard coefficient similarity. Now see this tree and this tree, so you can work with this, you will love that. So I will tell you how you can convert it today. Only two things I will tell you. One, how you can draw by using the draw tree and drawgram, that program, how you can work with the file, and then how you can convert, save this file in PASTA and again open it into Omega. When you save the file in PASTA, that you can't open it directly in Omega. Either you have to work with the file or you have to convert that by using the TreeView software. Open that PASTA file in TreeView and save it as a file format, and then open that file again into a Omega software. Then you can work out anything. So PASTA, because in case of PAST you have a number of Euclidean distance is the one option over there, or number of other options are there, so you can save that files. That is the one thing. Okay, then this was the tree. Now I just given a name. This is one of the main important thing, how I can name him. Mycoplasma pneumoniae, Mycoplasma genitalium, I can remember this. Mycoplasma galliseptiacum or Mycoplasma penetrans, synovi or agalacti or pulmonis or arthritis or mobilis or hyponeumonia, mycoids or capricolum. So this is what I have just given, because short name I was writing, because 103 organism hai. And I given M is for genus name and 3 later P and E for species name. And these are all 1000 bootstrap, and this is showing 100 times they are coming. So 99 it was just the same group, okay, just these two, mycoids and capricolum, they were. So similar with other patterns, but when I studied the Clostridium codon and such and other patterns, so the tree was different. Okay, so in this way you can make, how I can. So okay, if I have a Staphylococcus aureus, both number of species, 14 species, different strain were there, so I've just numbered them 1 2 3 4 5 till 14 strain I was having. Okay, 14 strains of Staphylococcus aureus I studied, so that I numbered them. But even Streptococcus I was having more than 5 strains, so Streptococcus agalacti 3 or Pyogenes having 9 species I was working with genomes, so I named like that. So if you file, when you are creating a FASTA file, in that only you just label it properly, just after the greater than sign, so that you will get, means your naming will be, and that is the coding system. Otherwise what happens, you know that. See, if you once one go ahead and error appears, ki nahi, similar name file if mein. Or even that also good for us to remember coding. If you don't go do the coding, so it will always a problem. Then it's a shuffle of files. Another thing, always make a set of file. First day apne jo kehta, okay ki ye is method se, okay, put that all the file in that folder. Data management of, while working in the bioinformatics, data management is better thing. I've seen most of the files they placed and sir problem, and that was difficult to find that file in that particular junk of files, which file you are trying. And always it happened that ki input file you missed, you are just confused to which file is that. So better whatever the day you are managing, so always work with, because phylogenetic analysis you are doing, so you may need to work with a number of tree. Final tree will be okay, you may select 4 or 3, but till that time you have to work with, means you got this, okay, intermediate files are number of distance matrix, then again you are working the parsing, bootstrapping, again that file, uska data. So this is, so better way, plan it how I can work. This is also the planning. So because of this planning I could work with 103 genomes. Actually my synopsis was of just 10 genomes, and I worked with 103 genomes. So program software I developed and database, so total data was around 15 GB, genome 4 GB, and then analyzed data. So Excel sheets were around 309 Excel sheets are there, Excel, just Excel file. and in each Excel files there are around 5 or 4 Excel sheets. So that was the management, huge data was that. So it's really difficult to manage such type. So better way, I was working along, so that's what I can tell you. So while working on a computer, you should manage this data. Okay, but another things, okay, don't rely on the molecular data, better you have to compare. That's why I've given a books, I thought, jo maine diye, it's a good book, bahut purane. Can I rely on morphological data or molecular data? That's a good statement, comparative accounts has been given, so better you go through that. And you will come to know, can I rely on morphological data and molecular data? If you get morphological, morphological is the final, because you should understand. But molecular data, if you are RAPD or RFLP also, try to do some SSR region if you are working on a higher organism or VNTR region. It's easy. Some companies also provide you the sequencing if you are diversity working also. But correlate your data, morphological and both the things. Okay. And I told you all the tricks. So, okay, you can go for a morphological data, either you can use the presence or absence, binary matrix, or you can use the frequency data. That is also good. Okay, and pasta is the software, it's easy, but try to use the phylip.